What's happening, guys? Keith here with your August 5th edition of the Impact Report. So if you haven't checked out my review of this past week's episode of Impact, you can do so by clicking the link at the top of the screen. And speaking of this past week's episode of Impact, it drew 248,000 viewers and ranked 138 on Cable's Top 150. Unfortunately, this was Impact's lowest viewed episode of 2018. Very surprising considering the fact that there was so much buzz coming out of Slammiversary. So last week and this week's episodes were lower than I had expected. However, I do see it jumping up next week with the announced title match of Austin Aries defending against Eddie Edwards. Generally, the title matches help out the ratings, so hopefully we see an increase next week. So let's head over to the YouTube numbers and let's look at the top three viewed videos from this past week's Impact. Number three, Scarlett Bordeaux will not be hot shamed. This brought in 65,000 views. Number two, Eddie Edwards assaults Austin Aries with a kendo stick. That had 98,000 views. And number one, LAX attacks the OGs with an axe. 169,000 views on that video. Not a surprise, as it is a kind of shocking headline for a video, so at least the views were up there. So unfortunately, we learned that Johnny Impact has suffered a dislocated elbow. This happened during a parkour and functional training shoot for muscle and fitness. Johnny wrote, "It turns out baby oil and parkour don't mix well." So hopefully Johnny has a speedy recovery. Very unfortunate news since he just returned at Slammiversary two short weeks ago. So we also got word that Impact will have a new show on their Twitch channel, and it will star Stone Rockwell. It'll be IRL Adventures with Stone Rockwell, and this premieres August 9th at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. That is next Thursday at 5 p.m. We also learned that Border City Wrestling will have their 25th anniversary show on October 6th. This apparently will also serve as an Impact One Night Only show. Some of the stars listed is Johnny Impact, Eddie Edwards, Sammy Callahan, Matt Sydal, Eli Drake, Kiera Hogan, Scarlett Bordeaux, Moose, Petey Williams, and Kongo Kong. And also listed is former BCW champions Tommy Dreamer, D'Lo Brown, Chris Sabin, and Johnny Swinger. So that is October 6th at St. Clair College Gymnasium. So on this week's Impact teleconference, they were joined by LAX. They started talking about how great Slammiversary was and then a little about their history with the OGs. They talk about the Wrestling Media Con in the UK next month and that this will be their first time wrestling in the UK. They are also asked about the reincarnation of LAX and why it has done so well, considering the fact that many reincarnations of teams fail. They say that this is an extension of them and they are not playing a role or character. Everything is authentic. They were ready to swim when they were thrown in the deep end. They are asked about facing the Young Bucks on the Jericho Cruise. They say that one of their goals has been to wrestle the Young Bucks, and this match is going to put them in the spotlight. They're both very excited for the match, as both teams are on top of their game. The Impact World Tag Team Champions at LAX's, and the Young Bucks are the IWGP Heavyweight Tag Team Champions. They are asked about who they gravitate toward backstage in Impact. They bring up Abyss, Sanjay Dutt, Gail Kim, and Tommy Dreamer. They say that Sanjay has played a big part in how the LAX storyline has been going, and they say that everyone backstage is willing to teach and learn. More positive information about backstage at Impact. They are asked about their wrestling idols. Santana mentions Bret Hart, as he is one of the wrestlers that got him into wrestling, and Ortiz brings up Christopher Daniels as he talks about getting into wrestling in the 2000 period, which is when Christopher Daniels was on top of his game. I mean, the man is still wrestling, which is incredible. And they say that 2018 has been their best year for their career. They say each year gets better than the previous one. They're asked about what Conan's most important advice given to them is. They say that Conan tells them to stay humble, stay hungry, and be easy to work with. Be the person that everyone wants to work with. Also, no matter what the office throws at you, hit it out of the park. So great advice from Conan. They talk about wrestling in Puerto Rico and wanting to make a return. They're also asked where the feud with the OGs could go after a 51-50 street fight. Santana says the only thing left to do is to take it to the streets themselves. Ortiz really wants to wrestle inside of a cage. They're asked which tag team has taught them the most. They bring up the Hardys, the Dudleys, the Super Smash Brothers from Canada, and the American Wolves. They are asked about their goals in professional wrestling. They say their main goal is to make it over in Japan. And then they jokingly say that if they make it in Japan, they're never coming back. They're asked if they would like to defend the titles in an Ultimate X match. They say it is one of their favorite match types, and they would definitely be interested in that. And then they question if there has ever been a tag team Ultimate X match, which I think Ross didn't believe there was one. They're also asked what kind of match they would like to do, and they say they've never done a cage match, and to go old school, they would do a scaffold match and a strap match. And then they finish the call by hyping up Bound for Glory, because it will be in New York, and they hype a surprise for Bound for Glory if all the pieces fall into place. Very curious what that would be. Maybe something to kickstart the Young Bucks versus the LAX match for the Chris Jericho Cruise. Maybe have the Young Bucks show up and attack them. Who knows? Maybe as we get closer to the show, we will know a little more about this, or we can at least speculate a little more. So not too much else to talk about. Last, I have that Austin Aries is officially set to defend his Impact Wrestling World Championship Friday, August 17th in New York City for House of Glory Wrestling at High Intensity 7. This is an open challenge, so we are not sure who he will be defending against. So that is pretty much all I have for you guys today. Shorter episode, not much else to talk about. Hopefully stuff happens over the next couple days, and I will see you guys back here on Wednesday and then Friday for my Impact review. So thanks for checking out my video, and until then, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.